permanent residency for your entire family. Means your family and your parents. Yes, please. This only takes 2 months. Imagine you get a permanent, sometimes a visa in India takes you 2 months. We give you the permanent residency with the cards in 2 months. It's valid for life, so there's no, you don't have to come back every 1 year to renew. It's valid for life, as long as you hold the property that you invested. Again, it's ready to move in freehold properties. If you don't want to live in Cyprus, you take your cards and you come back to India and you can rent that out or do business or whatever you want. There's no stipulation that you must stay there. So you can invest in a holiday home and use the cards to your benefit. And it gives you visa-free entry, obviously, because you're a permanent resident to Cyprus anytime you feel. This is what the Cyprus PR card looks like. You can see it on your screens. It's on the system. It's a chip card. So every time you come, it's on your system that you are a permanent resident. So you don't have to, you know. The airlines recognize it. The immigration in India recognizes it. The immigration in Cyprus recognizes it. I traveled on this, so I know. It's very simple. I'll just show you, I've got a lot of videos, but paucity of time, I'll just play one for each country. With these kind of facilities, with no noise, no pollution, clean air, no traffic jams, no noise, no nothing. You cannot get that even in the outskirts of Delhi, as you well know. Right? So, even if you don't look at PR, you just look at sheer investment. India versus Cyprus. Tell me what you get for this price in India. Yeah. With this kind of facilities, this kind of air, and this kind of location. On top of that, the icing on the cake is you get your PR. So if you just look real estate to real estate, there's no argument. There's no debate. Okay. So that was all about Cyprus. We talked about the Cyprus passport, and we talked about the Cyprus permanent residence. Now we talk about our last product, which is the Greece permanent residence. Greece, as you know, is, I mean, you would all know about Greece. It's more popular than Cyprus, but it's further away. The capital city is Athens. It's a historical city. Everyone knows about that. This particular program gives you by the way, Cyprus got 4 million tourists last year, just the country itself, which means it's a lot of, there's a lot of tourism, means your property, there's a good time to do business, because a lot of tourists come in, whether you open a shop or a restaurant or handicrafts or even a mini hotel, that business comes in, or rent out your apartment to Airbnb or whatever. Because of the influx of tourists, you know it's a good thing. 4 million. On this island last year. So let's go back to Athens. So Athens is the capital. Greece has got about, I think, 4,000 islands. It's further away to the west, as you can see in the location. It's also an EU member country. It's beautiful in terms of, I don't know how many of you have been to Greece, but wherever I have, you've seen how beautiful it is. Beautiful Mediterranean waters, blue waters, and these images that you see, this is from Greece. Again, very healthy climate. There are 428 beautiful beaches. Blue flagged beaches means it's safe to swim, clean waters, no pollution. There are 6,000 islands, part of Greece, so you can spend a year just hopping to various islands. Everyone talks about the healthy, the food. Mediterranean food is supposed to be very healthy. English is also widely spoken. And again, this particular program costs you about 2 crores. Okay, that's 250,000 euros. This particular Greek permanent residency, again, it's a permanent residency and not a visa, comes to you within just 10 to 15 days. Okay, again, it's meant for your entire family. What it also gives you is gives you a access to Schengen. Means you can travel across the Schengen countries, visa free for life, not only you but your family. Whoever got the card can travel across all of Europe and Schengen countries like you travel from Delhi to Bombay. If you want to go to Bombay now and book a flight, you can take a flight because you don't need to show. Same way, if you get a flight now, go anywhere in Europe with those cards. No thinking, I have to go to embassy, apply for a visa, give my bank documents, blah, 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 and you get a 2-week visa. This is again, the way the Greek card looks like. So it's got a chip, your phone, it's full biometric is there, so no one can steal it, no one can misuse it. It's also, and this is the link which is all on your USBs to tell you that more details if you want to know. You can get it from the official Greece website, the government website. I'll show you a short video on one of our projects. We've got about, multi-projects in Cyprus and Greece.
European location in the South Mediterranean, Eastern Mediterranean. This means the weather is good. 10 months of the year we have sunshine. It also means that these closest European countries to India. When you travel towards Europe, first you come across Cyprus, an hour and a half after that, an hour and a half flight after that is Greece, and the next European country is 1 hour after Greece. So Cyprus is the closest one. The location of Cyprus and Greece is the crossroad between Europe, Middle East and Asia, and Africa and the northern countries, Russia and Scandinavia. This means that throughout the history of Cyprus and Greece, they were the trading posts between the Roman Empire and the Greek civilizations to make business with the rest of the world at the time, which was the Phoenicians, it was the Egyptians, it was the Mesopotamians, it was the Indians. So there was always a lot of trade between the nations. The third is that we are at the period that is a very good time for investment. When I invest, I look for a place that because of some reason the prices were low, have dropped, there was some kind of financial turbulence, economic turbulence in the area, and this is going away. We saw this in Cyprus. There was a banking crisis in 2013. The economy and the prices dropped. Now since 3 years they stabilized, and the last 2 years they started growing, but still they are less than what they used to be, so we have space to grow. I'm sure you follow about Greece. Greece has also passed its difficult financial times with the Greek economy reducing. And now Greece has also passed the turnaround point. So if you're thinking of where to invest, now is probably the best time for both countries. All economic indicators to do with real estate, economy, credit ratings, they're all extremely positive. So as an investor, I consider now to be the best time. The other thing I want to point out that the tax, not only tax on profits, but tax on running expenses in both countries is very good, especially in Cyprus. We have zero property tax, no matter how much you own, the tax rate is zero. We have zero inheritance tax, which is quite unique for Europe. And so the tax for a European product, in addition to the two citizenship, two immigration programs, makes investing in real estate very special. Because a good time, you get a good price, there is little tax, and you get immigration benefits on top. I don't think, I cannot think of another time that it was such a combination of benefits. And finally, I want to say that both in Cyprus and Greece, we have discovered natural gas in the sea. Nobody understands what will be the effects of this natural gas, but everybody understands that there is a lot of natural gas that we found in the sea. And I believe the effect on the real estate will be phenomenal, because the gas creates real estate demand for infrastructure, storage factories, housing and offices and infrastructure. So in addition to all the rest, we're going to get another huge boost to the demand for real estate because of the natural gas. So another good reason why now is the time to invest. Finally, I want to say about the excellent relationship between the India and Cyprus and Greece. We, especially with Cyprus, we are both parts of the Commonwealth. We have both gained our independence in similar times. From the time of Mahatma Gandhi, there was a close bilateral relationship with Cyprus. I saw yesterday driving around doing a bit of sightseeing, and saw the Archbishop Makarios street just near the New Delhi golf course. We do have a Mahatma Gandhi street in Cyprus. Our late president was married to an Indian lady, Mrs. Leela Kiridis. Relationship between the two countries is very good. And if you visit the museums in Cyprus, you will see a lot of Indian art, which was donated back from the period of Mahatma Gandhi, Indira Gandhi. There was a special ceremonies here for the plantation of the Park of Peace, if I remember correctly, some 30 years ago, and our leaders were planting the trees in these parks, and reciprocal to Cyprus. So the time is good, and the moment is now. I do not believe there will be another opportunity for Europe to be so lenient in the immigration programs that you can have the immigration benefits just because you invest without having to have a residence obligations. So having said that, I'm happy to take any questions you may have.
You can take this.
And this is it.
So you mentioned about the PR program last year. So is it PR program alone or is it
both? Both. For example, you'll all know of Hiran Nilani. Uh-huh. He's one of the people who took a passport last year. And there are a few more famous people who've taken
it. How many out of this 6,000, how many are facilitated to you?
Through us? We would have done about 15-20 of these.
15-20.
Like I said, India we just started, so we are a bit late.
So there's another other players?
Other players, there? Yes. But we have just started India 6 months ago, so we are a bit late in India. So obviously we did not have the share. But now we will obviously, now that we are present, we also have offices in Bombay, Delhi and Bangalore. So because of that, we saw that there's a trend of Indians moving to Cyprus. So it came as a good surprise for us. And that is why we opened up the offices to facilitate. We've got advisors in each of the cities to help people understand and book them for inspections to Cyprus.
Fantastic. But I think the 6,000 also includes other forms of Indians who is coming to Cyprus. It includes, for example, students. There is good universities in Cyprus, including one of our universities. And Indians
Indian,
is...
A, Indians, it is a million plus, I don't
Is investors would be upper middle class and upper class, yes. Typically, the investor would be a business person.
What the amount you are asking, 2.5 crore, it is one time or it is section by section?
The permanent residence is one time.
One time.
Well, it's one time. I explained, it's once you buy the property, it's a one-time investment, and you get your property and your title deeds and your cards.
Okay.
Then there's only the maintenance cost, which you have to do for, which is 70, 80 euros per month. If you convert that, it's about, what, 16,000 bucks per month, 16,000 rupees per month. Is that all you pay to maintain your property?
And with all the facilities.
Or with all the facilities. So it's a one-time cost. There's no renewal fee. There's nothing like that.
So there are just two questions.
And passports.
And passports.
And students and working in Cyprus, because in Cyprus we have a big international business community and they need talent. And so they invite talent from India.
So out of that, 20 were facilitated by you, as you said. And secondly was... for the permanent residency thing, you have to invest
2.5 crores.
2.5 crores. So is there any other way in which you can get permanent residency, or is it the only way in which people get permanent residency?
This is a fast track permanent
residency.
As a fast track, there is no other way.
So anybody who approaches you will have to buy a property and do fast track.
Correct.
What are the other options besides property? Are there other options also? Like, suppose you go...
No, you may apply to the government for a residency, yeah, but this is a very long process.
It takes 5 to 7 years.
Oh, I see.
Vis-a-vis...
It is only 2 months.
Yes.
Thank
so,
you.
So like you normally apply for citizenship in any country, you have to go through the paperwork, the process, the lawyer. 5 to 7 years is the minimum time. Vis-a-vis 10 days, 60 days, 6 months.
And if anybody goes through Leptos, all these things are taken care of?
Yes, we
facilitate.
We have our own in-house lawyers. So everything is in-house, so you don't have the pain of going to different people to facilitate.
Those expenses are separate, right?
I've mentioned the expense, but that's a one-time cost. Yeah. So you buy a property worth 2.5 crores, then there's a registration fee which you have in India. There's you know, all those typical fees, lawyers' fees. After that, you're done, and it's only maintenance.
What is total cost?
Sorry?
Total cost.
I mentioned that in the thing. It's about 13 lakhs, right? Is the additional cost. One time. Yeah, additional cost.
So as we see, like, there's no direct connectivity to the airport from the airport. So what do you like to say about it?
Well,
not
that I can say. Yes, you're right. There's no direct flight yet. You have to go through the Middle East corridor, but there are enough options to get to Cyprus between Emirates and Etihad and Qatar Airways, Gulf Air, Oman Air. So, but there is a stopover in the Middle East, and then you connect. So the connectivity is pretty good. The usual wait hour is 2 to 3 hours before you connect. But you're right, as of today, there's no direct flight.
But there is direct to Athens.
There's direct to Athens, not to Cyprus.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we hope.